This is the air blower version 1 that I made years ago using scrap parts. And the reasons why I made such monstrosity, well, you can try to guess it, but I bet you never will, as I made it for two very specific reasons. To vastly speed up the ignition process in a grill and regain the loss in heat when coal covers an ash. And it worked quite well, but like you see, it is so annoying to handle this thing. Well, that's why I finally decided to make version 2 of it, which turned out to be just on a completely different level. To make it, this time I will be 3D printing instead of using wood. This way everyone who wants to make it can just print the parts. So I spent half a week designing it. At first I wanted it to look something like this. It will be safer and I thought it will give more concentrated and higher airspeed out of the duct. And I was wrong, I was really wrong. You see, this time as I am not using scrap parts, I wanted to make blower cost effective. That means using an inexpensive small high speed brushed motor and some basic propellers. Sure, you can go the extreme way and just buy an RC ADF motor that has power to blow everything out of the side. But this needs around 300 watts of power. You'll be walking with a backpack filled with batteries. Well, let's get back to the more sensible way of approach, because that affects design a lot. The shaft of a motor is only 2.3 mm in diameter. To mount a propeller firmly is a hard obstacle if you want that sucked air go down along the motor. That would provide a great cooling for it, but the propeller would want to go off the shaft. But if you reverse the airflow, you just need to make a slightly smaller hole and push it on. The pressure will always force the propeller onto the shaft. But here is where the main problem arises. I did some tests and I saw that additional duct will heavily reduce the airflow. I know it's a very raw test method, but the faster air rushes to this fan, the more voltage it will generate, and this doesn't look good for a duct. But could it be the propeller's fault? So I did some research about them. In one study I found that the outer ring can actually increase the static pressure of a fan, and in another that more blades on a propeller will give more pressure at a higher flow rate. And this is exactly what I need to force the air through the duct. So I printed this, and this has to be it. It even looks like a fan blade in the jet engines. Higher RPM gives you more pressure, check. Outer ring, check. More blades, check. But there was still a noticeable loss in airspeed. At this point, I just decided to go for the open frame and not a foolproof design. You'll still get the air suction from the back to cool the motor, and the short housing will be wider to protect the blades. So I printed the duct that will hold the motor, then the big and sturdy handle, and the bottom part in which will be the speed controller and on-off switch. I use a PTG filament, it has great lay adhesion, can withstand high temperatures compared to PLA, and parts turned out to be very rigid. A small downside of it is that you can get stringing, but you can easily rip most of those strings and eliminate what's left with a lighter. To assemble, you will need to follow a few steps, so let's talk about them. The motor will fit perfectly in the hole and you will need to secure it with two bolts and washers. At the top of a handle will be two holes for the inserts. These are usually used in wood, but works great with non-brittle plastics too. To attach both parts, you will need two bolts and washers. Later I additionally glued both parts with epoxy, as those won't need any disassembling in the future. The bottom part where speed controller and button will be attaches just with 6 screws. But before you do that, first it will be easier to press in these tiny inserts. You can do it very easily with a soldering iron and a scrap wood piece. This will give that perfectly flat surface. It looks excellent so far, so it is time to put electronics like the PWM controller, button and wire everything up. But before that, we'll need the last part, the battery holder. In my case, it is designed for the Dewalt 18 or 20 volt battery. It is annoying that all these manufacturers have their mounting types and there is no universal solution. but I spend more time and redesign battery holders and other parts for two other brands, Milwaukee and Makita. I will provide all SketchUp and STL files on my Patreon page. I know, not free, boo! But look, this project takes so much time to properly design and you can get them for only price of a nice cup of coffee. So I hope you understand. Huge thanks to everyone who supports my work. It really means a lot. But let's get back to the wiring. If you have the same battery, you'll need few of these spade terminals. We will push into the contacts of the battery. We need to hot glue them and the part with the connectors. And with some editing magic, we can skip the boring soldering part. If you don't know how to wire up all of this, here's a scheme that is very easy to follow. Now we just need to secure the bottom part with 4 bolts and we are pretty much done. So now it is the time for better tests. I made this distance airspeed measuring test setup and started testing various configurations. I tested the 3 blade propeller, 3D printed one, both with ducts, old air blower and the previously mentioned EDF motor. And here are the results. I compiled them into this chart. First, the most obvious thing that I noticed is that propeller type made a huge difference when placed into a duct. Free blade design had only left 62% of its original airspeed performance. Meanwhile, 11 blades managed an astonishing 89%. When compared to different propeller designs directly, no duct performance was slightly better than free blade design, but when placed into the duct, results heavily favored 11 blades. It looked that this is a great result for a 3D printed propeller, and not only that, but it also managed to get a higher airspeed at longer range than no duct configuration. But what if we try something a little different like this guy? Well, I didn't expect these results. It actually produced higher airflow speed with a duct than without one. It even surpassed the open design of free blades. This has to be it, the best design so far, right? And I almost believe that until I checked the power consumption. Free blade design draw around 2 amps at 19 volts, but 7 and 11 blade designs draw twice the current. We're talking 40 versus 80 watts of power, and those two designs are not even close to producing twice the airspeed. We're basically just overloading this tiny motor and it runs very inefficiently. So there's yet another important factor, the motor itself. It also doesn't help that 3D prints will usually have these imperfections, that will result in more vibration at high speed and reduce the potential performance. Another thing to note is if you repeatedly remove and add this 3D printed propeller, it will deform to a point where it is no longer usable. In my case, free blade design propeller mounting is far from perfect, but it has basically zero vibration compared to the new 3D printed one. At this point, it is very clear that the free blade design and the open frame is the best choice in this case. But how it will compare to the EDF motor at the same wattage? Well, the measurements were almost identical. That is such a great result for this propeller and brushed motor combo compared to the expensive brushless one. So here you go, from all the theory and testing, there is no doubt that a fan design is a very complex topic. To fully understand, you probably need to study fluid dynamics for quite a while. For everyone who will decide to support my work and wants to make this project, I will provide an additional details like what settings to use when printing, how to get a perfect fit for a 3D printed propeller and more on my Patreon page. This turned out to be a very interesting topic for me. In the future, I will probably test more 3D printed propeller designs and share my thoughts on them. Like I said before, designing, filming, writing scripts, making voiceovers and similar stuff takes a lot of time. So if you liked the video, hit that like button, it actually makes a huge difference and it gives a free way of support. Thanks to all who do that. And if you are new here and you like this style of video, make sure to subscribe for more future content. This is a different style of video compared to my older ones, as now I try to show more of a building experience, decision making, interesting facts and findings. If you are a long-term subscriber, I hope you like where things are heading. That's all for me, and we'll see you next time.